Dylan, are you typing into your microphone?
Yes.
Are you typing on your microphone?
It's a weird thing. He built a microphone / keyboard hybrid.
I know. It's pretty nice.
It's really not smart, to be honest.
All right.
It's incredibly convenient.
You guys ready to continue our epic journey?
Sure.
Through this is our continuation of playing Final Fantasy 1 on the NES. Keith, unfortunately, couldn't be here. He had better plans, apparently.
Like what? What would he possibly be? What could be better than this?
I don't know. There's a lot of schoolwork, maybe. I don't know what he does. I don't know what it is that he wastes his time on.
Like quality things like this. Keith Car Battery.
Keith Car Battery.
Keith Car Battery.
Oh man, that's so good.
That's really good.
Put that in your pocket. Save that for later.
I am. That went right in there just now.
Great.
All right, so let's jump in. So I haven't played this at all since.
So we're picking up where we left off with Bridge Built.
Bridge Built. That's actually not true. I actually restarted the whole game so I could make Keith a thief because it's what he wanted, and then he doesn't even have the decency to show up.
Terrible.
It's awful. But yeah, so let's cross this bridge. The main reason I wanted to play Final Fantasy again, apart from the fact that I just enjoyed it, was didn't even get to the late title card.
That's right. The awesome late title card.
I didn't even know this game had a late title card.
Yeah. One of my favorites.
I've not played so much.
The latest of title cards.
I want to point out, you know, while we're still early in the stream, that one of the main reasons that I'm joining you for this,
okay,
is that this is one of the rare opportunities I have to completely ignore the stream while I'm on audio. I call it pulling a Kyle, where I'm from. So I'm going to be playing Monster Hunter while you play.
Man.
Nice.
Guys, that's not how we do it on this stream.
Oh, we actually have to pay attention on this
isn't Phil's stream?
Well, it's too late. It's already happening.
Oh, man.
I am kind of watching StarCraft.
This will be the last time.
I don't think that's true. My understanding, you know, Kyle was talking about this before we went on air, and he didn't want to tell anybody. He doesn't want to make any promises. I'm willing to tell people, though. We're going to be playing through all the Final Fantasies.
One by one. Wow.
I did actually, because I wanted to play Final Fantasy 1, but I couldn't, like, change the save file, like, I couldn't play past where we were here, I downloaded Final Fantasy Origins on a PS1 network, and I tried those out, so I tried Final Fantasy 2 for the first time.
Oh man, Final Fantasy 2 is rough.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't love it. I was surprised by like the narrative leap between the first and second Final Fantasy.
Sure.
Final Fantasy 2 kind of, I mean, it starts off mostly the way, like, the way you think of a JRPG starting off, you know, like the same level of story and characters and stuff.
Yeah, there's a lot more story in it. They also do that cool, like, keyword thing. I actually kind of dig that.
Oh yeah, that was weird. I didn't get a chance to dig into that too much. But
yeah, basically, like, you'll talk to certain NPCs, they'll give you information, that'll give you a keyword that then you can ask other NPCs about. It's a little bit like an adventure game.
Yeah.
But I would love to see, like, more RPGs do that. I thought that was kind of cool.
Yeah, that's neat. Oh, there's a cave here. And I did actually, I grinded a little bit, so now we're right next to level 3.
Ooh.
The third level. I kind of read up on some of the stats here in the NES version of Final Fantasy 1, and there's some weird things, like, this person could have been wrong, but it sounded like the luck stat is, like, only for running away.
Really?
That seems right to me. Because this was before, like, there was much of a standard for that stuff.
Yeah. I mean, there was Dungeons & Dragons.
Yes. But I mean, like, specifically in JRPGs and,
Yeah.
They were like super simplifying Dungeons and Dragons for this game.
It's true. I still love that magic system though.
Somebody in the chat room points out Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate comes out in like 3 days. I'm playing it right now, guys.
How lucky are you?
I'm hunting monsters left and
what's
right.
What's that for?
Wii U and 3DS.
The U version of Wii.
Can they play together?
Yes, actually. But yeah. only locally.
Oh.
For now. They're adding in the ability to do multi as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, I'm sure they are.
Yeah.
It's going to be patched in. But, like, one of the people in your party has to be playing on Wii U. It's weird.
Okay. No,
it's Capcom.
Well, I'm still not going to play Monster Hunter, so...
Get out of hand. I think bad things are about to happen.
This is not looking good.
Oh, man.
I have plus life, though, by a lot. So that kind of makes me feel good.
This is gonna...
It's a lot of wolves.
It's gonna be tense, you guys. Oh, man! And now my cure is wasted, isn't it? Oh, shit.
Yep. It is. Shit. It's the only fast cure on a corpse. Oh, no.
Oh, wow. That...
Things are going bad.
This is not good.
Oh, no.
Hooray!
Phil, your hat...
My whole party perished.
Phil, your hat came off.
Well... I guess I'll live with it.
Welp. Thanks for tuning into our stream, everybody.
We're done for today.
But as our rules state, once we get a full party wipe, we must end the stream.
What is respond rate?
That was a shitty rule.
that was an ill-conceived rule. Guys, remember this title screen?
I love this part.
Oh man, I can't skip this. Oh, I can't. Okay, I can speed it up. Respond rate is the like text crawl speed, or like it's like the message speed. There's no text crawl in the game, but it's how long the message windows will stay on the screen. Are you guys gone? Am I alone?
I'm here.
I'm here.
I'll never leave you.
I was scared. Getting back to like the weird statistical eccentricities of Final Fantasy I, this thief I have here is basically terrible. There's nothing good about the thief.
So wait, just to clarify, you're telling me the gameplay decision that Keith made is terrible?
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm telling you. The thing about the thief is that his high stat is agility, so he's good at evading attacks, but not good enough to avoid a lot of damage, and he can't wear good armor. So, like, his strength and defense are both worse than a fighter, and that's... And he
just
doesn't
have
anything else.
Just have him use backstab.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But what sounds cool is apparently once he, like, once he digivolves into a ninja, he gets a lot better and will be able to do low-level black magic, which sounds pretty cool.
That does sound pretty cool, actually.
Yeah, I seem to remember the ninja being pretty awesome.
Ninja's the best class in Final Fantasy XI, for what that's worth. Best tank.
Someone in the chat saying Red Mage is good at public relations.
I don't know what that means.
Got luck up.
Morgan R. Park's wondering about the best Final Fantasy that isn't 7.
10.
6. Yeah. 10's really good, though.
10 is very good.
Speaking of Final Fantasy 10... I was just watching one of the newer episodes of Replay. It was the Parasite Eve episode. And it was, like, yet another video in which, like, Dan Reichert tries to decide if a game from Japan that is an RPG is a thing he might enjoy. And he's going...
I can tell you the answer.
He's going on and on about, like, how he just, he has no patience for it, and everything we've heard a million times, and the stories are weird and everything. And then there, someone mentioned Final Fantasy X, and he was like, oh yeah, like the opening cinematic is amazing. And someone was like, I thought you didn't. He's like, whoa, well, I love Final Fantasy X. Just like, I don't understand this person.
Yeah, not at all.
I had to work with him.
Final Fantasy X is slow. To start, like, very slow.
Doesn't it? Somebody reminded me recently that 10 starts off with Blitzball.
Well, it starts it starts with a Blitzball FMV.
Okay.
Now, the beginning of Final Fantasy X is awesome.
And that's why Dan liked it so much. It starts off with sports.
Yeah,
like,
maybe.
Fuck, yeah.
It's people trying to get Dan to accept, like, or at least give a video game a try. It's exactly like trying to get a little kid to try something other than chicken nuggets.
You should have seen us trying to get him to try different foods. Like, no, that's exactly it.
Exactly.
Emotional Hobo says Dan Reichert is a well-crafted persona, and he's right.
Yeah, yep. I think that's half the. I think that's half of it. It's like he doesn't want to try other things because then he won't be Dan Reichert anymore.
No, that's totally it. What was it from the sandwich place near?
Yep. He didn't know he hadn't tried mayonnaise.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yep.
It was like garlic aioli, and he loved it.
Yeah.
And then, like, you realize that's mayonnaise, right?
Yeah. I remember he was. Yeah, he was trying to play it off, being like, "Well, no, it's not. It's not that I didn't want. I didn't know I hadn't tried it."
If we're gonna talk about Game Informer shit, are you guys caught up at all on the Super Replay Showdown?
I'm not.
Not.
It's going pretty good.
Did Kyle win his match?
He did not, I believe.
Yeah. I don't...
That was the match.
I didn't
that was
think
the match
he
where
would.
Where Ben Hansen had them do karaoke.
Oh, great.
He had them do SingStar.
Oh, every single game that Ben Hansen chose for the first Super Replay Showdown was perfect. That was
he's
like,
making some pretty killer choices again.
That was an A+ showing.
Yeah, he's.
Oh man, these things.
Ben Hansen is a mad genius. He knows what he's doing.
Guys, I gotta go back to town. This is going bad. I don't.
You have to go back.
I didn't realize I would need potions so soon because I didn't need them at all at the beginning of the game.
Oh no.
I was wondering where the difficulty of Final Fantasy 1 was, and it was hiding beyond the bridge.
It was immediately after the bridge.
Yeah, right after the title screen.
Do you have your heal spell, right?
It's, well, not anymore. It's all gone. I have to go wait until
how many
until
can you
tomorrow.
Use per day?
3 right now.
Okay.
Oh, well,
I think
actually...
it goes up with your level.
Yeah, I think once I go to an inn, it'll be bumped up because I just leveled, so...
Okay. Battle music is great.
It is pretty good.
I'm glad that this is the game that we got sound over Skype working on.
Because it's... Oh, because you can hear it.
That's the most important. The voice acting is really helping.
I actually really wanted to start doing Nier on this week's stream tomorrow.
Oh, God.
But what? Then I was like, I think that would be hard to do... With people on Skype who can't hear it.
I've been curious about that game. I'm fascinated by the fact that the main character was completely redone for the Western version.
Yeah, that's bizarre.
It's kind of understandable. It's almost genius.
Well done, Square. That is Square, right?
Yes, I believe so.
Thought so. People say they don't make good games anymore.
Well, to be fair, it was not Square developing. It was Kavya, who I believe doesn't exist anymore.
Okay, well, there you go. So it wasn't Square, then.
Yeah, never mind.
Square brought it over, though.
Yeah, but Square published Deus Ex, also.
Yeah.
But Keith and I did a live stream last night, and that was the first... Well, that was the first Skype live stream that we had done at all. But it was nice to have the audio so we could discuss, like, the mute, because we played, among other things, no, this is the wrong store. Among other things, we played, The Lion King and Aladdin for the Genesis, and those are two games with great music.
Two games where the SNES version's better, yeah.
Oh, man. Well, there was some debate about this among the chat when we were playing The Lion King, so I bought the SNES version of The Lion King so that we can compare. Because that was the thing. I could have got the Super Nintendo versions, but I had always heard the Genesis versions were better.
Aladdin, I feel like there's a lot of debate. I don't know about Lion King. I don't know that people talk
Lion
about
King
Lion
King. Lion King is better on Super Nintendo. Sounds better.
The one thing is that I know, or I shouldn't say I know, but I'm almost positive that Aladdin has a password system on the Super Nintendo. Not on the Genesis.
I think that's right, yeah.
On a Genesis, you gotta start from the beginning, buddy.
Really? There's nothing? There's no way?
There is nothing.
Huh.
It's harsh. So weird.
One of many reasons, I guess, that the Genesis version is worse.
Perhaps. I don't know. We'll have to find out. Stay tuned, livestream Retrospect viewers.
I still know the level select code for Lion King on the SNES. You just hit B-A-R-R-Y at the title screen.
I don't know that I ever passed that game, but that was one I rented a bunch.
Boopin' Doop in the chat says, ugh, fuck Dell.
Yeah, alright, sure.
Okay.
I can get behind that. Let's do it.
I don't like Dell computers either.
No, guys, I was told we were gonna fuck Dell.
Also,
I
don't have one. Oh, no. Oh, wait, alright. Let's get some more magic up in this.
Kyle, are we gonna fuck Dell or not?
I don't think Dell is here. I mean, it's not that I wouldn't, but I feel like we would have to go find Dell. You know?
I feel like I was tricked.
Another thing I didn't know until I played the Final Fantasy Origins version of this game is that mages can only learn, or any character can only learn, 3 spells per level, per magic level.
Yeah, right. Do they,
so
the Origins
4...
version? I played the Origins version, but a long time ago.
Yeah.
Do they put in an MP system there?
No, it's all... They didn't change that much. That would have been crazy.
They changed that much later, in some of the later FF1 versions.
No way.
Yeah. They make the game significantly easier in that one of the ways.
No way. I did notice, though, the Origins version is... Now, I didn't play past the bridge, so I don't know. But I know the portion of the game before the bridge was actually a lot harder. Like, the Black Mage does a lot less physical damage, which makes sense, because it's a mage.
I want to say...
About this fog.
The GBA version is maybe where they start really making some crazy changes.
And, Ruse. What was Ruse? Let me get out my handy Explorer's Handbook.
That instruction manual is pretty useful.
Ruse. The enemy is fooled into seeing multiple images of the magician. Evade rate increases 40%.
Seems useful.
He'll be a practically be a thief at that point.
Yeah, and that only affects the white mage.
Spell.
And it, bleh.
Or ninja spell.
Ninjas can only learn black magic.
Oh.
Let's,
Final Fantasy XI.
I learned that lit is lightning.
Makes yes.
Sense. They should have put an N. It should have been lit N. That would have made more sense.
What is lock?
Yeah, I'm looking that up. I think it's paralyze.
Oh,
no. This is really confusing. And this is... Locks in is in quote. Locks in the enemy for attack. The success of inflicting damage increases by 10%.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Terrible.
So it basically is like a... It's just an accuracy boost against a single target.
Lovely. Super useful.
Slep is causes the enemy to fall aslep, leaving him unable to defend himself.
Of course.
Let's get some of that slep in here. I feel like slep could be useful.
More so than lit?
I could. Let me take a look at lit. Litning is fired at the enemy from the magician's fingers. Damage ranges from 10 to 40 points. And that's the same damage range as fire, so I don't really understand the... Maybe some enemies are...
Elemental!
Yeah, maybe some enemies are more weak against lightning. Against litning.
Guys, I'm hunting carpenter bugs.
Phil, is that game not stupid yet?
Yeah, actually, I'm enjoying it where I am now.
Okay, cool.
I got past the 8 hours of shitty tutorials, and now I'm enjoying it.
Yeah, no thanks. I'll be playing Final Fantasy 14.
You showed him.
Yeah. Yep. Take that,
Take that, Phil.
Mads Fox is wondering if you're reading the manual or a guide.
I'm reading the manual. I keeps it rel.
The manual for that game seriously sounds impressive.
It's really good. You can, if anyone wants to see it, vim.net, V-I-M-M.net has like a ton of manual scans, including Final Fantasy. That's why I bought it, because I could have just used that PDF that was online, but I just thought it seemed really cool to have the manual.
Yeah, I agree.
Oh, these wolves.
There's a lot of them, too. Isn't this what screwed us the last time?
No, the last time was, The last time was purple wolves?
Oh.
It's a different thing.
Much more
completely different. It's like a whole different species.
No, seriously, though. Please don't die to these wolves again.
No, these... I never died to these wolves.
Right?
I am! I just want us to also make progress here.
You know what, Phil? I am going to, take even greater care to defeat these wolves because... I'm encouraged to know that you feel like you're a part of this.
I do. Well, I'm the Black Mage. That part specifically.
Exactly.
Set the wolves on fire.
It's, Anyways.
Do you think we should? Think we should try Nier? Should we do that?
I thought we were gonna do that shitty dragon game.
I feel like I would be more excited about any game choice if we weren't committing to playing the entire game.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's always how you feel.
How long is Lair? Or is that what it's called?
Nier.
Talking about?
I could have sworn you said you were going to play that awful PS3 six-axis dragon game.
That would be a good one to play, because from what
I'd be interested in that.
From what everything I heard about it when the game came out was that the only thing that made it awful was that it had mandatory motion flight controls, and they fixed that later. That could actually be a good game now. I have no idea.
Yeah.
I mean, it's probably not, but it could be.
I mean, I even heard the story was good, which is not even a thing I would go to that game for.
I mean, it's Factor 5. It can't be a bad flying and shooting game, right?
Yeah, that's... I mean...
They're good at that.
I mean, apparently it was, because of the controls, but...
I'll just give the... Like, it got fixed, though.
Maybe. I mean, I know it got patched to have analog controls. I don't know if they were good.
Oh.
Okay, we've entered the cave.
I'm excited.
Ooh.
It's purple!
This is some good music. I'm gonna turn this up a little bit.
That's good stuff.
What is that? It looks like a broom.
It is a broom, I believe.
Why is a broom in a cave?
What? Oh. Push B. Select. What?
B and select.
It doesn't do anything.
Just remember it.
Maybe it was just like, hey, push select, because then you can do this. Whoa!
Don't put me up there.
I'll go wherever.
I don't know if this even affects anything, though. Wow, this music is good, though. Oh, speaking of which, whoa, this place is creepy. Dylan, you're talking about you're playing this Hatsune Miku game.
Yeah.
Because you're like, hey, it's rhythm game.
Mm-hmm.
But have you played Theater Rhythm?
I haven't played Theater Rhythm.
Dude, you gotta play Theater Rhythm.
You don't have
rhythm.
A 3DS, do you?
I do have a 3DS.
What are you doing then?
Get Theater.
I'm fucking up, I guess.
Yeah, dude, seriously. That game,
pretty fun, man.
That game
Why
don't
you is... tell me that before I spent $75 to import
it to Japan? If you can't put these things together yourself, I don't, like...
Fuck. It could actually be good music, too. God damn it.
Yeah.
This witch lost her crystal.
Is it available on the eShop?
I think it is now. I'm not sure.
Anyways, I bought it for full price on a cartridge. I feel pretty good about it. I also tried out the free version.
Lucky enough to play that game for review, and it's awesome.
Yeah, I actually tried out the free version of the iOS version.
Oh, I play an iOS version.
And it's not as good though.
Isn't it like super microtransaction-y?
Well, you have to buy the songs in packs, and. The songs, you buy them in packs for each game. Each game has 3 songs, and they're $4 packs. And then if you multiply that by 13, that becomes at some point, I think, if I'm doing the math correctly, that becomes more than the 3DS version for less songs and worse graphics, and that's...
Yeah,
the whole thing is disappointing.
I played the demo for Harmo Knight.
Oh man, I gotta... This looks bad. I don't want part... What?
How was Harmo Knight demo?
It's pretty fun.
I was thinking about checking that game out.
Pretty hilarious.
No.
But you can, in one play, you can play all the levels over and over again.
I'm gonna try. What the fuck?
Harmo Knight is cool though. That's my recommendation, based on the demo.
Oh, okay. Okay. I put the ogre to sleep.
Oh good.
Oh good.
Okay. Oh, wow, that's awesome. I got freaked out because it didn't ask me to select a target for my sleep spell, but it affects all of the enemies.
Everyone is slap?
Everyone's asleep right now.
That's great.
That worked perfectly.
Perfect. This is probably overkill.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I played a bunch of Final Fantasy IX this week.
That's awesome.
Yeah. It's a lot of fun.
Final Fantasy IX is really good. I think it's underrated.
I really like playing as Beatrix.
Maybe the game gets better after the beginning, but I always found the beginning pretty underwhelming.
What? We have to, like, do the play fighting, and
yeah.
Then the hunt is cool.
I guess that stuff's alright, but then immediately after that, you're, like, stuck in the woods, and I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know, something about it never grabbed me.
Disc 2 is really good. Like, it's slow after, like, you get to the woods until Disc 2.
This game is hard.
Also, I like Mint Synthesis a lot. I wish more games did that. Is that Casting Fire and Slep?
No.
Or...
It's a select.
Oh.
Jeez.
Feel Fire and Slep would be very effective. Oh, I died.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate.
I'm unhappy about all of this.
This is... Yeah, not...
None of
Everyone
this...
Everyone else pretty good except for me.
None of this is what I want. Yeah, they seem okay until you realize that some of these enemies, or maybe just the ogre, were doing like 25 damage per hit.
What are those things, creeps?
Keith couldn't make it for an undisclosed reason. And undisclosed by him, not
what?
Me.
Could you disclose it?
No, I don't have the reason to disclose.
Should I text him? See what's up?
Though, that's chaos time asking that, and, it reminded me that...
Why don't you just give chaos time his number, and then he can call up Keith and find out why.
Yeah, I should really do that. One of the fun things about putting the chat into the video is that when I watch it back, I can read all these things that I wasn't able to see the first time. And I think it was even like, it wasn't even the first time I rewatched it, but it maybe was like the second for like editing. I noticed, it's like you notice new things every time. So I was just watching it right before we went live and I saw chaos time at one point come like, what is going on in this stream? The email for it woke me up and it's 3 a.m. here. What's going on?
What?
It was fun.
That's dedication that he got out of bed at 3 a.m. to...
Oh, because he got an email.
To try and figure out this shit.
Chat, and I assume everyone in the chat is a... Oh, wow, that's a lot of experience points that Dylan didn't get because he's dead.
That's fucked.
Wow. Well,
thanks a lot.
I assume everyone in the chat is a Final Fantasy expert. If I use a tent, will Dylan come back to life?
I don't think so.
Not
I'm not 100% sure, but I don't think
oh,
so.
Oh, I think I have to go to the church. So. I must have to go to the church.
Lovely.
Someone says no, so... Oh, I had potions! What am I doing with myself?
Fucking around. Thanks a lot.
I'm fucking up. I didn't use any cures.
I'm continuing to drink. Seems like the best call right now. I'm so depressed about my own death.
Understandably.
Yeah.
You need to stop that. Hey! Imps. Whatever, right? Wait, why does Keith only have 18? I thought I just checked his HP. I'm gonna drink. Just like Dylan.
Sounds like a good idea. I don't like this death position that I'm in. Like, feet up.
Yeah, we're not really not showing your body any respect.
Absolutely not. Like, just threw it on the dirt.
They keep... I like that.
I stopped Kyle. I was like, should we take a second and bury Dylan? And
that's
like, no,
he's making that up.
Drag him back to the goddamn church.
Well, Phil, if you knew you could bring your friend back to life, you wouldn't be burying him.
Well.
Yeah, well, alright.
A respectful one.
Are we talking about Dylan?
Oh, dear.
So,
friend? I don't know about.
When. So. These, those Final Fantasy Origin games, are pretty weird, because they weren't made for the PlayStation. I looked at it, and they looked like Super Nintendo games, and then I looked it up, and they were WonderSwan Color games.
Oh yeah, I kind of forgot about that.
They were WonderSwan Color games ported to the PS1, and then later ported to the GBA.
Seer 235 suggests hiring one of those imps to replace Dylan.
Imps don't know shit about cure.
Yeah, they don't know white magic.
We need our heals back
and,
up.
And I'm a white magic expert, Phil. What do you know about white magic? Nothing.
You're being hella racist
oh,
right now.
Oh man, is Dylan worth
it's
40
not white
gold?
White pride magic.
Dylan,
oh,
you,
40 gold.
You're costing
Jeez.
Me 40 gold right now. I hope you realize that.
That's almost not worth it.
Did you say white pride magic?
I said it's not white pride magic. Just white magic.
That's messed up. Chaos Time says, why the magic gotta be white?
That is a good question. How come... Well, never mind.
Loot!
I better not. Never mind.
Guys, I'm playing you my loot right now. Beautiful music fills the air. Do you like that?
I do.
I guess?
What is pure? Pure water?
I think it's like a heal status ailments thing. Let's tent, or let's in.
I was gonna say, don't waste your tent.
I set up a tent in the middle of town. These guys are weird. Dylan, you're making white noise.
Sorry.
I'm not happy about it. Guys, would you fix your shit? Me and Keith did a live stream last night. It was the best sounded thing I've ever heard with my ears. It was beautiful. You're fucking this shit up.
I've heard better.
You have no idea what that last Final Fantasy stream sounded like. It was a travesty. But I also partially blame the chat. But also I blame myself because I promised myself I would never believe the chat ever again when they told me the sound was good, but we were in a rush, so the chat said the sound's good, and I went, okay, probably good.
Wait, what was the
problem?
Was
it not good?
The problem was that I was way too quiet. So that was already a problem, and then when
That's probably why the chat was like, yeah, this sounds fucking great.
Yeah.
And then when I ran it through Levelator, which fixed the volume issue, but then it just meant that anytime I was talking, there was like, there was just a bunch of noise that you could hear, and it was just awful. And so I was able to remove the noise, but noise removal also has a huge impact on overall audio quality, so now it just sounds like it's kind of underwater.
Yeah, that also sounds like a lot of extra work, too, which sucks.
It was a lot of extra work.
To YouTube. Actually, that's not even true. I tell Phil to hit the button that says upload to YouTube, and he does it every time.
Yeah. Yeah, that's actually a thing I don't think I've ever mentioned, but for anybody who watches our stream, or at least my stream archives after the fact, is that the ones on YouTube are almost always improved in some way to be better, so you shouldn't be watching the archives on Twitch. You should watch them on YouTube. And now I've got that local recording going, so I'll have something even better than what Twitch spits out. Wait, where am I going? I go east? Like a desert? Something? Wolves? Oh, wolves. It's like The Gray. Have you guys seen The Gray?
I have seen The Gray.
I haven't. I've heard it's actually good.
It's fantastic.
Yeah.
Most of what I know about The Gray is just Dan Harmon's impersonation of Liam Neeson in The Gray.
Oh. It's very
which,
good.
According to him, it's like 90 minutes of Liam Neeson talking about how much wolves don't give a fuck about things and will
kill
you.
There's a lot of that in there. There's a lot of like, how about we do this? And like, Liam Neeson's like, that won't work. Wolves don't give a shit. They'll kill you.
They don't give a fuck about slep spells.
That sounds awesome. You're terminating these wolves, though.
I am.
Also, like that Phil's attacks are ineffective.
Slep you, asshole. Terminator. Get it, you guys?
Well, I get it.
You get it?
I get it. I've heard of that movie before.
You've never heard of it, but you still get it.
Yeah.
How many more till we level up? How many more till we luck up? Oh, just 27s. Just 720p's more. Until up.
Can we make it to the second town? You're close.
Oh, God! Why? We should run from this. Oh, no. I still don't understand how running works in this game. I think it's like only one person needs to be successful at running to run. Is that right?
I believe that's right.
Because I've seen things where it'll be like, run, failed, but then one person... And
as
then...
long as, I guess, and it's affected by luck, you said, right?
Yeah, I believe so.
How weird.
Where's the second town? Oh, I'm so far away from my home right now. Oh god, what are these things? Oh, okay, I was looking at them all wrong. They look normal now.
I kinda wanna ban 420 Coon 69.
Oh, yeah.
That name is impressive.
You should probably do that.
I can't. Yeah. I'm not a moderator.
Oh no.
You took away my power.
How do I fix that?
I don't know.
Click on Phil's name when he types something in the chat.
Oh, okay.
I guess I could do that.
But I'm fighting mad ponies. Fighting
those
mad ponies.
Upset.
Like mad ponies right now.
Hey, Bleeding Heart is here. Hi, Bleeding Heart. Bleeding Heart joined me for my weird stream last night, where I played a bunch of random shit off of my Steam list.
Bleeding Heart is one of the people who convinced me to buy the Miku game. So that's worth something, right?
Oh, man.
Wait, really?
Mm-hmm.
Bleeding Heart.
She was one of my Twitter followers who sent me Miku videos that were awesome.
Oh, did you ever say a thing in the chat? How do I make you... Oh! Ignore, follow, timeout, ban... Unvoice.
Please don't ban me.
OP. I can make you overpowered?
Yeah, that's it. That's the one you want to hit. That's actually the one you want to hit.
That is the one.
I don't like these ponies. These are freaking me out. I think it's gonna break bad.
Why do I already only have 22 health?
I gotta fix this. No! Go, oh, Phil!
Oof. Oh no.
I can fix this.
Fuck.
I can fix this.
They're filming Breaking Bad here recently. I drove by the car wash and they were filming at it. Spoilers, there's gonna be a Breaking Bad scene at the car wash.
That's messed up, dude. Why are you
sorry?
Did the car wash blow up?
Not while I was there. Also, I was there today and it was still not blown up.
I'm gonna fog myself.
There was a billboard that said Call Saul, which was pretty funny.
Great.
Like, right next to the car wash.
That's awesome. How about now? Can you hear me now?
Hello, internet.
Chat! Okay, great. Yeah, there's some weird thing going on with my XSplit where, like, the sound won't work, and then I just mute it and unmute it, and then it works.
That's weird.
Okay. Alright, so, Dylan, I think, yes, experience-wise, you're catching up with Phil, because now we've leveled up, but Phil is dead.
Oh, good. Also, I just ordered a pizza from the internet.
Oh, did you slash pizza?
I did. I slash pizza'd.
Great.
In my browser, and it just is going to show up.
A lot of people will remember Final Fantasy for NES, the first game to introduce slash pizza.
Yeah.
Yeah, guys, you take slash pizza for granted now, but what you don't realize was back in the NES days, slash pizza was incredible.
I wonder if there's somebody who came up with that on the, like, Sony Online Entertainment team who, like, was really convinced that this is the future, that, like, this is gonna be in every game.
Maybe, I don't know. It's a neat idea, like, it's funny. You're like, oh, I could order a pizza by doing slash pizza. But I don't...
It's funny, but it's also something that I feel like if I was doing it, I would, while doing it, even though I order pizza online, but while doing it in-game, I would feel worse about my existence. I would just be like, oh, I'm playing an MMO. Because, you know, like, playing an MMO for long stretches, you already start to, like, hate yourself after
like
a certain point.
A sad fucker. It's true.
Right? Yeah. It was like, Dylan plays MMOs. He knows.
All
right.
Looks like
eventually you just start to cry for no reason.
Looks like I'm closer to the second town than the first town. I checked my map quickly, so.
My pizza's going to be here in 31 minutes, guys. But, that is oddly specific.
A wise man once said, slash pizza ain't a punchline, it's a lifeline. And I think we could all learn a lot from that.
Is that a Sean Elliott joint?
It is, yeah.
It's great. Good stuff.
Oh, man. Okay. It's probably fine.
Nope.
Oh, my black magic user is dead.
That's a bummer. So no slap?
No slap. I was like, don't worry, I'll just run. I'm just gonna run.
What is fog?
Fog is, it puts a fog around your own party member, making them harder to hit.
Oh. Okay.
But it actually raises their armor, so it doesn't actually make sense, but...
Oh.
Run. You guys, run.
Like, run button?
Yeah.
I'm just tying it all together. I'm just putting the pieces together for you.
It's really weird now whenever I hear people talking about, like, a button in a video game that makes you run. Because now I just notice it all the time.
Yeah, no, I'm the same way whenever I hear somebody mention polygons.
Yeah.
Like, my ears are like, wait, were you talking? And then I have to, like, remind myself that polygon is a thing that people talk about.
Yeah, earlier today it was two people talking about Mortal Kombat 3, and it was like, when I first heard about the run button, I was like, that sounds stupid. But then once I tried it...
Yeah, for a second, like, your heart picked up, you're like, oh, why do you guys hate run button?
Where's run button is great. Also good in Mortal Kombat.
Who's this Which guy?
It's not bad in Mortal Kombat.
What? It makes that game like so fast, it's great.
Hey, Phil, did you want to read this?
No.
Oh, come on.
I actually don't know how to read, and also I'm fighting a dinosaur.
Come on, guys. Dylan, can you read this like a pirate?
BK the Pirate.
That's close enough, I guess.
Yeah. Surprised I am that you scurvy dogs have the nerve to face me, mates. Get those landlubbers.
Oh, no! Fuck! That is so many pirates!
Oh, yeah, that's the, that's like the boss battle.
This is great.
Oh, no! Who would make a game where this happens?
Square Enix? Soft?
I mean, I think you could have gone to the inn first.
Yeah, of course I could have, but it's not fair. Like...
I like Sergeant McDee's answer also of just Japan.
Yeah.
Oh, man. We might have to just do this.
What are you gonna do exactly?
I like that the pirates look more like samurais.
They look more like the fabled ninja pirate hybrid.
Yeah.
The ultimate race that will kill us all.
And kind of Viking-ish, too, with those helmets.
I think I can do this.
It's gonna be tough, but I believe in you. Vigigames points out, just drink all the potions.
That's not a bad idea.
These guys are pretty weak.
Sear235, I like his reaction. Why is your first reaction in town not to heal, but instead to fight pirates?
I was looking for the church.
Who does that in a town?
Uh, I feel I know he's joking, but I feel like a lot of times when people criticize, and it's not like Keith and I are great at games, but I feel like a lot of people criticize us because they have knowledge of the game and we don't, and they can't like put themselves in our shoes. So that, like, we'll be playing Silent Hill, and they'll just be like, why would you not do this? Why are you just walking around doing nothing? It's like, because fucking Silent Hill is confusing.
To be fair, you both wear very tiny shoes.
It's true.
Comically small.
Not a lot of people could fit into them. So I'm now imagining the guy who's like, why the fuck would you go straight for the pirate?
Hey, you did it, though.
I did do
it.
Wow.
Fuck
Nicely
pirates.
Done. A lot of experience points that we did not get.
I couldn't even tell that guy was a pirate. Oh, now that I know he's a pirate, he totally looks like a pirate.
See this shit, Dylan? This is just like in real life. We're second rate on the run button crew.
Sweet! I got his pirate ship! Because, you know, that code of honor in pirates, if you defeat a pirate in battle, they must submit their ship to the victor.
We're playing for pinks, actually, so just like in Fast and Furious.
Yep. That's exactly right. The elves live across the sea.
That Pirates of the Caribbean Fast and the Furious crossover.
Oh, man.
Wasn't expecting it to be great, but man, it was awesome.
It turns out Orlando Bloom's character was actually Paul Walker's character's brother.
Oh. Yeah.
They were estranged, though.
How does The Rock fit into that?
I'm not familiar.
I got nothing. Ships can only stop at ports. There are no ports in the north.
No,
here's the Hart House.
Not a single one.
This world's fucked.
No one built a goddamn port.
No way! It's 80 each for you guys now?
Yeah, it goes up as you level up, I believe.
So
I've cost 120 gold so far.
And they get revived with 1 HP. Well, please, don't do too much for me. I would feel like the game is just handing me the victories.
The trick is that you really want to stop dying.
Yeah.
Yeah. You should probably heal before you go talk to people in case there's another boss battle.
I mean, come on, guys. What are the chances that they would put two boss battles in the same town? I'm fine.
Yeah. Seems reasonable.
Yep. Alright, I'll go there. It's because it's the whole town. I want to explore the whole town before I start... Oh, God, you guys... I experienced this in Dragon Warrior 2 with these NPCs in town. They're like path. I assume they just give them some like random script where they have an equal chance of going up, down, left, or right, and that just ends up with like sometimes the NPCs will like wedge themselves in the most inconvenient spots. Like one time in Dragon Warrior, I had to wait 5 minutes for an NPC to like move away from the inn door. Oh, there's the inn. Get out of here!
It's called gameplay.
Get out. You have to just start pushing them out. Get out. Out, out.
This is awful.
Kyle Churchill's pro 8-bit NPC wrangler. It's my new game coming out in the Activision O2 line.
Sarge McDee, also the second trick is not mistaking pirates in churches. he mistook a pirate for an inn. That's different.
Yeah, that's way different. What does Gandalf have to tell me up here? Oh, I already
He's
talked
boss,
to all you guys.
Actually.
Let's see if there are any level 2 spells for sale. That'd be pretty sweet. Mute, lamp, a lit. What is a lit? And invs.
If I had to guess, a lit and lamp, it seems like would do the same things.
A lit is maybe like alternate lightning.
I'll tell you. A lit. Oh. A lit, anti lightning, reduces damage received by 25 to 50%.
Weird.
Duh. A lit is anti lightning, dummies.
Of course.
Invisibility, 20% increase to ability to avoid attacks. Lamp, removes the enemy's dark spells. Mute, magic users are rendered unable to speak. Alright. Check out Mute. Mute could come definitely in handy.
Can we talk about Saints Row 4 now?
Do we need to? God.
Fuck yeah.
I'm extremely excited.
Okay, yeah, I totally want to do that.
That game looks awesome.
Yes.
Well, that trailer was pretty that
gangsta superheroes in space.
Well, you're in the you're in cyberspace.
Are you in cyberspace or real space?
Cyberspace.
I thought there was aliens.
Well, there can be aliens in cyberspace. You're basically
you're the goddamn president of the United States.
From what we understand at this point is that the entire game probably takes place inside the what they call the Dominatrix, a cyberspace reality. Because what they did, they announced a Saints Row 3 expansion called Enter the Dominatrix, and then later they said, actually no, instead of an expansion, we're making a full sequel.
Yeah.
So
the next great sequel in the Saints Row franchise.
Exactly. So it's a safe bet to say that a large portion of the game takes place inside the Dominatrix.
So they just like expanded Decker's Die to the whole game?
Yeah. I think you're going to spend a lot of that game punching Deck, maybe cracking ice.
I'm very excited.
I'm more excited now.
It has a date, August 20th.
See, this person understands. He says, Kyle, you tend to miss obvious things while LPing, but I'm not sure if that is just because Keith is distracting you. It's exactly what it is.
Keith's incredibly distracting. It's those piercing blue eyes.
Oh man, I gotta look up these I gotta look up these weapons.
Is this all in the manual?
Maybe. I'm just guessing. There's a lot of stuff in the manual. A lot of it's weirdly out of order. They explain the classes like halfway through the manual. I don't even know how that works.
That's weird.
The inns. Very important.
They're not lying.
That's with an exclamation mark. And this just says, buy potions!
Also important.
I mean, and it's... It's kind of interesting because it's a great manual, but it's probably a product of them understanding, like, Final Fantasy is a great game, but we need to teach people how an RPG works. Like,
yeah, I guess so.
They probably knew that it could be a huge hit as long as they they tried hard enough.
Well, Dragonware came with the actual guide.
Well, it was a mail-in thing.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The manual for Dragon Warrior has some info, but it's not great. Let's see. Let's see. Okay, Town of Provoca. There's one section with huge letters that just says, "Why can't I defeat the pirates?"
Wait, what tips does it give you?
If you're having trouble defeating the pirates, if you're having trouble, here are a few tips. One, spread out your attack. Don't have all your characters attack the same pirate. Have everyone attack someone different. Two.
Whoa, no, that's like actually the worst idea.
No, it's good because the pirates have really low HP, so they all die in one hit. So it's like
I was gonna say because you want to take them down, but I forgot the whole like weird missing thing.
Yeah, if anyone doesn't know, in this Final Fantasy, if you have your characters set to attack an enemy that just got killed, instead of just switching to a different enemy, they'll just attack the air.
Yeah.
It's great.
Which makes the most sense.
Use the sleep spell, and yeah, that's about it.
Oh, sorry, did you mean the slept spell?
The slept spell.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, here we go. Buy weapons, armor, and level 2 magic. In Provoca, there are some great shops. Da-da-da. Oh. I don't think they give me any, Oh, gosh. The sea will have sharks in it, you guys. Alright, well, whatever. Let's just buy one of these scimitars, I guess. Because I've got cash.
Yeah, I seem to remember the, sea, once you get on the ship... it's a pretty big boost in enemy power.
Really?
So you might want to just, like, grind for a while outside the city.
Yeah, I might have to do that. Alright, right now I do 20 damage, and if I equip a scimitar... 21 damage. Well, great. Let's go back and sell that. Huh. I can sell it back for the whole money. I can sell it back. Oh, just... Alright, never mind. What's up, guys?
Nothing.
Cool.
Is Dylan still here? Did he leave?
I don't know. I guess he's gone. Guess he's dead to us now.
He might have, his pizza might have showed up or
ice.
Something.
I have ice, slow, temper. Let's see. Ice! Cold and wind, damages range from 20 to 80 points. Dark, the enemy is blinded by darkness. Oh, temper. Weapon strength is increased by 14 points. It's pretty cool. And slow slows the enemy's thinking.
You want ice for sure.
Yeah?
Yeah, I mean, need it for, like, fighting fire dudes, right?
Hmm.
Eventually.
I'll definitely get ice. I think I'm going to get slow, or, I should get... This is hard, because I have to pick one of these to not get, and they all sound pretty good. But I think I'll start with dark, so I can blind any, like, ogres and stuff. Oh, sure. I already have sleep. Yeah, sleep, dark, and slow kind of all do the same stuff. Get some of that ice.
Sorry, yeah, guys.
Gonna crack ice.
Hey. Where were you?
I went to go get another beer. My pizza has not yet arrived. I'm kind of sad.
Terrified.
You know, speaking of Dragon Warrior, actually, I have, one of the things I think I'm saving for a stream is I have my Dragon Warrior save file basically at the final boss. That might be interesting, I don't know. Might be super hard.
Are you, like, leveled up enough to actually take on the final boss?
I am according to the player's guide thing, but I'm kind of at, like, the minimum.
Sure.
So.
It's a hard boss fight.
Yeah, I should probably level up some more. God, that's no damage at all.
As is the rule in Dragon Quest games, you should grind.
Yeah.
A lot.
Let's try out this ice.
I just saw Sergeant McDee calling sharks the purple wolves of the ocean. Like that.
Truly, this is the age of purple wolf sharks. Alright, Phil is up to level 4. Good job, Phil, everybody.
Well done, Phil.
Thank you.
What level am I? 3?
3. A lowly level 3. You missed a boss fight, my friend. What were you were sleeping
Whose
through
fault
it.
Was that?
You slept through that boss fight.
I was tired. I slept.
Let's see what... Okay, so we have one more level 1 spell at level 4. Yeah, I know, like, now that I know Dungeons & Dragons, I have a lot more appreciation for that magic system, because I know when I first saw Final Fantasy 1... And how you were limited to only a couple uses of spells at once. That was, like, it blew my mind. I was like, what is this?
It's crazy. Still.
Kyle, what do you think about this game so far? Do you feel immersed in the world of Final Fantasy? I should probate you for your use of te.
I didn't realize that somebody in the chat was asking that. I thought you were just like I thought you just fucking lost it.
That's because you're not paying attention, Phil.
I thought you just fucking gone nuts.
I got nothing from my stream, mates. My stream mates. So I had to resort to talking to myself.
Sorry.
Yeah, I mean, this game's cool.
These creeps are really awful looking.
I really like, yeah, these things are gross. I don't like this at all.
This is awful. Like, a giant pair of lips and teeth and moldiness.
How come that one never picked up as, like, a known creature from the Final Fantasy series the way that, like, Chocobos or Moogles did?
You should have replaced Chocobos.
You're saying, why are we not making plushies of creeps?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know.
No idea.
But yeah, I found... I guess... The last time I was really good with playing JRPGs was, like, when I was in middle school and stuff, and now any kind of, like, story-heavy RPG just kind of puts me to sleep, and I just want to be able to play the game and not really... Because, I don't know, I guess I just don't really like any of the stories anymore. So I like that these NES RPGs don't really have that much story. It's kind of what like, I was impressed by the fact that Final Fantasy II was so much more narrative-focused than the original, but I was also disappointed because I didn't really want to deal with
You'd
it.
Like the narrative.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Especially, it's like... It's why it's so hard to go back to something like Final Fantasy VI, because storytelling in games has progressed so much since then.
So I think VI holds up.
Yeah, I can't say that it doesn't, because I haven't put in the time. But I know it's... I think overall, gameplay in older games will holds up longer than storytelling does.
Sure, yeah. I don't think there were a lot of even SNES RPGs that were as ambitious as Final Fantasy VI.
Yeah, sure.
Which is maybe why VI holds up better than a lot of them.
Chrono Trigger is a good game.
It's a pretty good game.
It is, like... If you play Chrono Trigger for the first time now, like, it's not even close to the way people talk about Chrono Trigger. Like, that game's alright. Like, it's fine.
I think it's pretty
good. I don't...
Chrono Trigger's good.
I don't get it.
It's in the time period what could have been a lot of people's first RPG.
Which yeah, that too.
Almost guaranteed to be your favorite RPG for most people.
You're right.
That's the difference.
I guess it had non-random encounters, which was pretty...
Yeah.
Innovative.
What is it about Chrono Trigger that you hate?
The thing that I hate about Chrono Trigger is his goddamn hair. It's like, get a comb, buddy. Yeah, like,
that's understandable.
Just, don't just, like, let that out there. No, it's like... the story in Chrono Trigger, for one thing, is like... It's really weird. Like... The speed with which they are all totally okay with the idea of a time machine and going back in time is, like, incredible. They're just like, yeah, time machine, let's just hop in!
Oh, I think my slash pizza has arrived.
Where am I going? Finally. Oh. Potion shop. Potion shop, where are you? I don't think we've talked about this guy's sweet mohawk.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think the...
Phil, stop. No, Phil.
Gets a lot of
Phil.
Love.
Phil. Check Hold out on. This guy's mohawk.
I don't give a... I don't think the reason Chrono Trigger gets a lot of love is much to do with the story.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Like, I don't think it's ever been... Like, the story in that game has always been kind of like, oh, it's simple, but kind of fun.
Yeah, you're right. You're probably
not
right.
Like, that's the reason to play it. It's much more about the gameplay, I think.
Yeah. I mean, I enjoyed it. I want to finish it.
It's
but
like
also,
it's just a really tightly designed RPG.
Yeah, you're. That's true. You're right.
Like, the battle system's fun. Like you said, no random encounters, that kind of stuff.
I don't have a problem with random encounters. It's never really bothered me as much. Other people.
Yeah, I'm the same, but I understand why it bothers other people.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. It was weird in Legend of Dragoon, though, how they gave you, like, a... They gave you a thing, so it was still random encounters, but... Or it wasn't random at all, because you could tell exactly how much longer you had until the battle started.
What was it? I played that, but a long time
ago. Yeah, me too. It was... They just, like, threw an arrow over your head, and it started blue, and, like, as you ran around, eventually it would switch to yellow, and then it would switch to red, and then you would get into a battle.
They have that same thing in Etrian Odyssey.
You are cutting out.
Sorry, can you hear me now?
Kind of. You're still a little choppy?
I don't know what's going on.
Alright, it's probably fine. I don't know.
I was saying they have that same thing in Etrian Odyssey.
Yeah.
Where, like, it gets... You have, like, a little meter that turns red, and then once it turns bright red, that's when you're going to, get a random encounter.
Huh. Speaking of which, so they have this, well, maybe it was always in the PSN store, but I noticed a thing that they have in the PSN store, which is that you can arrange, like, any category of things based on how well it has sold, so it'll, you know, put up, like, the highest selling thing first and all that stuff.
Oh, that's weird. I didn't know they had that.
And I went and applied that filter to the PS1 Classics.
Okay.
And, so of the top four games, three of them were, like, totally obvious. It was, like, it was Final Fantasy IX, Final Fantasy VIII, Final Fantasy VII. But then okay. Number one, ahead of all three of those, was Legend of Dragoon.
That's really weird.
I was like, that doesn't make any sense to me.
Was it on sale recently or something?
That's a good question. I don't know.
Maybe it was, like, part of PlayStation Plus 1 month or something.
Huh.
Because like, I wonder if it would count, like, downloads from PlayStation Plus, even
you're
if
right.
It was free.
You're right, because it wasn't best-selling, it was most downloaded, so that could also be... The only explanation I could come up with was maybe it was one of those things where everyone's like, oh, of course I've played all those Final Fantasy games, but I always meant to play Legend of Dragoon. I don't know. Whoa!
PlayStation Plus.
That was... Yeah, you're probably right. Chat, was it on PlayStation
like, I feel
Plus?
Like Legend of Dragoon has some people who love it, but I feel like it's not that big
yeah.
of a
or PSN Store's download algorithm is messed up.
Or Sony is like looking at it and they're like, what the fuck? We need to make a sequel to this immediately.
Never has the success.
I have not done anything with this.
Never has the post-release success of an RPG been as great as we have seen in the PS1 Classic Store for Legend of Dragoon. Like, they just try to start this campaign of convincing people that Legend of Dragoon has become really popular. I only played the first disc of Legend of Dragoon. I always kind of wanted to go back, because I remember it being okay.
Yeah, I sort of was the same. I actually, my brother was obsessed with that game. And he like was not a big video game player, so it was always something that he was like, you should play this. And I was always playing like Final Fantasy games instead.
The way I heard it described recently, I forget where or who, but they say it was a great JRPG to play while you were waiting for the next Final Fantasy game to come out.
Sure.
You could turn into people with wings. Remember that? Everyone had, like, a dragon crystal. Or something. Or dragoon crystals.
I remember so little about that game. They never did make an actual sequel, did they?
No.
Yeah, I didn't think so. But Legend of Legaia did get a sequel.
Legend of what?
Yeah.
Legend of Legaia. Whoa. Such a good game.
Dylan, you just did 22 damage in one hit. I am so proud of you right now.
Oh, thanks. Also, I have excellent news. Internet pizza is just as good as pizza ordered over the phone or in person.
That sounds right to me.
Yeah, I wasn't sure of that until
that
just
only
now.
Makes sense because normally you would order pizza over the phone, but like think of how much more bandwidth there is for like if you're going over like a Cat 6 for your pizza, that's way more data.
I'm not saying it's the most efficient way to get pizza, but it is still as delicious. Also, Legend of Gaia was really cool. That was the one where you like picked like your little combos, like kick, kick, punch.
Yeah,
whatever.
Legend of Legaia,
Isn't that one
of my most depressing stories growing up, because I bought that game, like, one of the first games that I bought for my PS1 after I got a job in high school, and really, really liked it, and then ended up breaking the disc by accident. I think it was, like, a multi-disc game, so I even just, like, just broke the first disc, but I hadn't made it off of that, so I couldn't continue playing again.
That sucks.
Yeah, I remember being really upset.
Yeah, I'm so bad at finishing all games, but just JRPGs, to me, like, you know how some people get, like, really proud of themselves when they read a book because they just never do it? And they're like, look, I read a book, oh my god, it's amazing! Like, I'm the same way with JRPGs.
You don't give a fuck about reading books, though.
No, fuck that.
Who reads books?
If you wanted to- Oh god! There's so many wolves here! They don't give a fuck about reading books. This looks like a job for Magic Slep. No. Okay.
I believe in you, don't worry.
Two, three asleep. Four asleep. Alright, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Alright, it woke up. Never mind. I think the last time I had no problem finishing a JRPG was Persona 3. That came out, and I was still in high school, but that was summer vacation, so I just had two solid weeks where I didn't do anything except play Persona 3.
That's a weird one to be like, I had no trouble finishing one of the longest RPGs.
Yeah, I know. It was crazy. My final end time ended up being, like, over 100 hours, but it was because there were multiple times, and this almost never happens to me because I have such a hard time going to sleep, but I fell asleep with the game on. And then I would just, like, wake up and kind of, like, see that it was still on the TV and then just, like, pick up the controller and keep playing.
Just keep playing?
Yeah.
Awesome. That's fantastic.
And then I had so much JRPG completing momentum coming out of that that I went and played through all of Final Fantasy VIII right after that.
What's your feelings on Final Fantasy VIII? Because that's a
my feeling
controversial one.
Yeah, there are definitely things that I like about Final Fantasy VIII, and definitely things that I don't so much care for about Final Fantasy VIII. For one thing,
that's a real controversial opinion.
Yeah,
that game has things you like and don't like.
Really
about it.
Putting myself out there with that one, but I don't care who knows it. I don't, you know, sometimes you like and dislike things in equal measure. for one thing, here's what the story seems like to me. You know that thing of, like, there's, like, a guy, he's painting, like, the name of a store on a sign, right? Like, a sign outside a store, and he starts with, like, a big swooping letters, and then halfway through he realizes he doesn't have enough room left to finish what he's done, so then just, like, the second half of the name is, like, really scrunched up and tiny. That's what the story feels like. It feels like it takes hours and hours to get started. Like, it just takes its fucking time so much. And then right at the end, it's like, then 100 things happen, and then it's all done. And it was so weird.
Yeah, I completely agree with that. I mean, like, I kind of think that, at least at the time that I played it, I don't remember it that well now, but I remember feeling like, once I got to the end and everything happened, I was like, oh, some kind of really cool stuff went down in this game.
Kinda.
But it takes so long, and it's so, like, covered up by all this other shit.
Right, and of course, as we all know, Rinoa was actually a Dia, like, from the past or the future, or like a reincarnation, and Squall was actually that lion thing. We all know this, right? We're on the same page here.
I don't...
Have you seen... Have you not... You don't know what I'm talking about?
No.
Oh, okay. There was a person online who posted some, like, huge, like, thesis, I'll call it, on his theory about the real story of Final Fantasy VIII, and that was like...
Yeah, I think I have I've heard of this.
Rinoa is actually, like, the villain reincarnated, and this, and this, and this, and it just goes on, and gets crazier and crazier, and his closing argument for all of this was basically that, and also that he thinks everything past, like, Disc 1 is a dream and stuff, or something,
right.
Or, like, Squall dies at the end of Disc 1 or something, and he got to the end and was like, basically, I just really, really like Disc 1, and then everything after that I thought was really bad, and I refused to believe that it was just bad, so he invented, like, some elaborate... Perfect. Series of things to explain why it was still good.
That's what I'm saying, man. People who like Japanese games,
they like them a lot.
They're the worst.
Wait, what?
They are the worst.
Nothing. I wasn't saying anything about you. Don't worry.
I felt like someone was talking about me for a second there. That was weird.
Nope.
So anyway, guys, have you guys heard of Hatsune Miku? Oh.
The character? Yeah.
Yeah.
We've actually talked about it, like, a lot.
Yeah. Who was it that called it the main symbol? Oh, Kevin Gifford. Called
yeah,
it the main
right.
symbol of the race to the bottom in the Japanese games industry.
I like that.
That's pretty
and
good.
Kevin knows what he's talking about, too, so...
Oh, totally true. I agree, but... It's still fun.
You just don't care.
It's fun. I don't know what to tell you.
Kanaki Fried Chicken, which is a great screen name, says, "All I remember of 8 was my friend would never let me play it."
Aw. That's sad.
It is pretty sad.
All I remember of 8 is Squall is kind of the lamest character in Final Fantasy.
Yeah.
I don't know, I thought so, and then I just found out he's a lion or something? Fuck.
He's like a lion demon or something.
That's kind of cool. Does that make Snow the lamest character in Final Fantasy then now?
I think Snow is probably already the lamest character.
I think most of the characters in 13 might be in that running. I don't know.
Snow is the worst. Well, Hope is pretty bad.
Hope is pretty
fucking
bad.
Hope is bad, but they make Hope better in the second one, and they don't change anything about Snow.
Let's hop on this boat. Let's see where this boat goes.
Let's just stop talking about that second game.
Vanille's voice is intolerable, and I'm usually not even a person who complains about characters' voices.
Those, like, porno sounds during battles are pretty awful.
I don't remember those. Oh, here's something. Here's the one thing that's terrible about Final Fantasy Theater Rhythm. There's kind of a version of it, but they didn't just put the Final Fantasy 13 battle theme in that game, I don't think.
That's a very good song, though. That's a bummer.
Yeah, how do you mess that up? It's at the very least, it's not in, like, the main progression of songs that you play. Because, like, half the songs in that game are unlockable, I think.
Yeah.
The Dark Notes.
Is One Wing Angel in it? That's my favorite song.
Of course it is. How could it not be?
Yeah. I love One Wing Angel.
Yeah.
Who I were right the first time.
Who is the person that actually says that?
I don't know.
There's a lot of them, dude.
I don't know.
I hate everyone. I hate all of them. Those people.
I mean,
this is what I'm saying when I talk about not liking people who like Japanese games.
Like, I think there is a lot of great music in Final Fantasy VII, and I'm not saying that One Winged Angel is bad, but
it's
like,
totally not bad.
There's so many greater pieces of music in that game that how can you pick One Winged Angel? Like, I don't understand where you come to that conclusion. Is it... I guess it's just because, dude, Sephiroth, right? I'm getting my ass kicked right here. None of my guys can hit these things. Okay, I gotta get out of here.
Sephiroth isn't a good bad guy either.
He's going
bad. I hate
bad.
Anyone who says that.
Yeah, you know how you said, like, anybody's first RPG is gonna be their favorite? Final Fantasy VII was my first RPG, so I have absolutely, like, I cannot judge that game at all. I have no, like, concept of anything about it. I can't tell you if any of it is good or bad. Except for the music.
I can tell you.
I can tell you if the music is good.
I could tell you, but...
No, I think 7's alright, but it's obviously overrated. I don't think that's...
It's fine.
Yeah, but I mean, like, it's... That's easy, because it is so... highly rated.
Yeah. I don't think it's, like, totally awful the way some people do.
It's fine. It's great.
There's been, like, some of the backlash against it being so overrated has been, like, extreme in the opposite direction.
Yeah.
Which is also undeserved. Materia is very cool. Like,
I have...
The story's interesting.
As somebody whose first RPG was Final Fantasy VII, I think Materia is pretty awesome.
Yeah. I like the Final Fantasy IX system the more I've been playing it.
Yeah, it's good. It's real good.
It's actually the only system that has gotten me to pick anything but the best equipment always. Like, it's always a choice between what spell I want to learn and what kind of stats I get.
Guys, Sphere Grid.
Sphere Grid, very good.
Yeah, it's really good.
Sphere Grid in International, extremely good. Because you can pick any class. Like, right away, as opposed to waiting a while for the old Sphere Grid.
It's, We'll do a couple more grinds. Then I might switch to Dragon Warrior, I don't know. I might do that.
Ooh, thrilling.
I don't know. I'm gonna slap these guys. I think someone's asking for binary domain. Keith's not here. What?
Yeah, but are you ever gonna play it while Keith is there?
Well, I'm certainly not gonna play it while he's not here. Don't be crazy. Someone in the chat says, "Well, I am frankly bored." I don't know what to tell you.
You don't have to be watching this, bro. You have the choice.
I'm open to suggestions, except playing Binary Domain without Keith, because that's just silly. Emotional Hobo says, play gun.
Alright, yeah. Fuck it.
Ugh. Ogres are no joke.
When are we switching to gun? I'll turn off Monster Hunter for that.
I already have the NES hooked up, so we could switch to any number of other NES games.
It's Monster Party.
Just say an NES game, I'll tell you if I have it.
Monster Party.
No.
DuckTales.
No.
Ugh, never mind. RBI Baseball.
Yes.
Ooh.
I did actually, I got like a free copy of RBI Baseball at some point. But also, I am the worst at it.
Perfect. All right.
Okay, yeah. I guess that is perfect. Lester the Unlikely. I saw that on the shelf at one of the game stores. I almost threw up. I'm reading the chat's things. Someone says Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, which seems like a great idea.
Do you own Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles for NES?
No. Why would I own that game?
Man, that game's
because fucked. Everyone who's ever owned an NES ever has owned that game.
All right.
It's kind
Well, the thing was, I lost my collection, so I had to start over. So if you're starting over, you don't go for that game. But how was Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, like, arcade or whatever it was? Like, didn't they make another one?
I don't know. Yeah, they made a version of the arcade game, I think. Then there was Turtles in Time, but I think that's Super Nintendo.
I think you're right. Play something that's possibly super duper. Actually, technically, I have... It would be really easy to just hook up any of the classic consoles I have here.
TurboGrafx. Hook up your TurboGrafx.
Yeah, I really need to get my TurboGrafx out.
Do you have a TurboGrafx?
No.
You should get a TurboGrafx.
But I already... I don't want a TurboGrafx, please. Don't do this to me.
I know if I mention it, then you will probably buy it.
I've been really thinking about getting an Atari, though. I could get Yar's Revenge and Air Sea Battle. Other things? Keystone Capers?
Sure, those are all games on the Atari.
I could get Adventure. Perhaps
I bet those games would entertain you for, like, upwards of 3 minutes.
Perhaps you've heard of Adventure.
I actually haven't. I have Adventure on my Xbox 360.
Yeah, me too, but it's not real, though.
Well...
What? Maybe you've heard of a game called Pitfall?
I actually haven't.
E.T. the Extraterrestrial? I've heard. I've never played it, but I've heard a lot of good things about it.
I would like Let's Play of that. I would watch it.
Pac-Man? The Pac-Man?
Well, which one? Pac-Man or The Pac-Man? Because they're both good, but they're different.
Kanaki Fried Chicken says, E.T. isn't actually not a bad game for the Atari.
That word is confusing.
Yeah. The first time we did a stream for Final Fantasy, I spent the whole time grinding, and in retrospect, no pun, I realized that was not really necessary, but I feel like now it is.
Have you gone into your boat yet?
Yeah, I went in and I got into a battle, and my guys couldn't even land a hit on any of them, and I ran away and then got off my boat because it was scary.
How many level ups have you had since then?
Zero.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, to level up.
Now I have this stupid fucking thief ruining everything for me.
Did you go north? Because there's no ports to the north.
I've heard there's no ports to the north, that's true.
Yeah.
I have heard that. Like, because I was like, yeah, I mean, the thief sucks ass, but, I mean, it would be fun, right? I mean, the game's not that challenging so far. I didn't realize it was going to get so real. You know?
Like, deep?
Oh, I have no white magic
like
left.
Like, real emotional issues.
Terminated.
Hey, Kyle.
Hey, what's up?
Good work.
Hey, thanks.
Just want you to know I'm here supporting you.
We could also play Simon's Quest.
Yeah, I'm into that.
All right,
yeah,
fine.
Yeah, why not?
Let's beat Simon's Quest. Because I'm right at the end, and I'd really like it to be done.
I thought you don't finish games. But, like, all of the games you're talking about playing, you're almost done with.
Yeah, I've been playing a lot of NES games. There haven't been a lot of real game releases, though. Real game releases. Recently. But to keep up my reputation of not finishing games, haven't finished Tomb Raider.
You should do that.
Probably should.
It's really good. Let's play Tomb Raider.